For our first episode, this is what we have for you. The 2018 Ford Mustang GT Convertible. Now, this model is up a few horses from the previous one. It has 25 more horsepower, which gives you an additional 20 pound-feet of torque. So the specs are now 460 horsepower and 420 pound-feet of torque. Now, the outside of the car has also been given an update, but they are subtle changes, except for one glaring difference: the lack of a roof. And we'll talk about that more a little bit later on. So let's start with what we see on the outside of the car. It still has the classic large muscle car sort of proportions, but it's a lot leaner and a lot sleeker now. It has a redesigned hood, larger air scoops. It still has the large front grille, but the headlights are now slimmer, more angular, and they're now LED. We also have redesigned fog lamp housings, more angular, a little more triangular in shape actually. And towards the back, it's got a new spoiler design, a new rear diffuser, and the triple bar taillights have also been updated. It's also sporting a quad exhaust system now instead of the previous model's twin. Now, the look of the convertible is still up for debate. Some people do prefer the more classic fastback shape, but the convertible certainly has an appeal of its own. Now, over on the inside, there are some subtle changes as well. It still has the overall retro sort of feel, but things have been updated. Now, let's talk about the upholstery. It's got some nice black leather upholstery on the seats, perforated leather on the center panel, and textured leather on the outside. The leather wrap on the steering wheel is really soft and supple. It's actually among the softest that I've ever felt. The steering wheel size is a little larger than usual. It also aids in the retro vibe. Now, there's still a bit too much of cheap, chintzy plastic on this level of car that I'd like to see. But there are some nice things to talk about as well, like this brushed aluminum panel that you have over here. It's got this brushed aluminum effect. These three circular air vents, which also give it more of a retro feel. It has an 8-inch infotainment system that features Ford's Sync 3 system, which will support both Apple CarPlay and Android Auto. But one of the coolest features of the updated car is the instrument cluster. Let me show you how it works. All right, now it's a fully customizable system. It doesn't have any physical gauges or clocks on there. It's all virtual and electronic. But the nice thing about it is you can fully customize the graphic look and the colors of the various gauges and dials on there. You can choose through here. You can choose your primary color. And you can also choose your secondary color, which will then give you a very customized sort of look depending on which driving mode you're using. As you can see, when you toggle through and switch from sports mode to normal mode, the actual look of the gauge changes from virtual dials to this bar graph sort of look. Now, if you change to sport into track mode, it also has a different look altogether. It's fully customizable. You can choose what information you see, including cylinder head temperature, air temperature, and for track mode, it'll also give you various telemetry, like how many G's you're pulling during braking, or how many G's you're turning right, or how many G's you're turning left. There's a lot of information there, and it's a very, very cool customizable system. We are driving the 2018 Ford Mustang GT Convertible through some city miles, and boy, it is a fun car to drive. Now, the thing about this car is really the wow factor. You get a lot of appreciating or appreciative glances, whether you're driving with the top on or the top down, even more so, in fact, with the top down. It's a beautiful car, and a lot of people appreciate it. In terms of impressions of the car as you drive through the city, it feels pretty close to the previous model that we had the good fortune to try as well. But this is up 25 horses. It gives you an additional 20 pound-feet of torque. And in my opinion, you do feel that. It feels like the car really wants to run at full gallop. It's got a new 10-speed transmission. But you do feel the car sort of trying to find the sweet spot amongst those gears as you drive through city miles, especially if you're running pretty free and you slow down to bumper-to-bumper traffic or slower traffic. You do feel the engine sort of trying to match the revs to the appropriate gear, and you do feel it as a little bit of a physical manifestation of that. It's not the smoothest of cars that I've tried, but then again, I think that's the appeal of muscle cars like this. Is you feel the slight rawness to it. There's a slight edge to it, and it does feel pretty good. Now, they've actually borrowed the MagnaRide suspension straight out of the Shelby 350, and it does a great job whether you're on city streets that are smooth or on bumpier conditions like we more often experience here in Manila. Make no mistake, it's a firm ride. It's a firm, sporty ride, but the MagnaRide suspension does sort of knock the square edges off those bumps. It makes them feel sort of a little more rounded over. You do feel the imperfections on the road, but they feel a little rounded over. So it's a comfortable enough drive. In terms of how it feels in the city, it's got ample leg room, ample headroom. Feels quite good in terms of comfort. Visibility is also not bad. It is a tall hood. It does sort of rise towards the middle of the hood and then drop down towards the front. So the hood does ride a little bit high, but the visibility is still pretty good nonetheless. Steering feel is also very good. It's something that you can actually tailor. There are toggle switches down here towards the center console, which you can switch the steering feel from comfort to sport to track. It varies the feel of the steering, a little heavier during more spirited riding, giving you a chance to hear the howl of the V8 there. We're traveling at relatively low miles. The nice thing about the exhaust is you can tailor the exhaust note via electronic switches here on the steering wheel. You can run it in quiet mode when you're driving out of your garage through the village and you don't want to bother the neighbors too much. And you can switch on to a more a louder growl as you hit open road, which will give you the chance to appreciate the beautiful exhaust note coming out of those quad pipes in the back. One thing to mention, though, is the fact that it's a convertible. That's the biggest difference to the previous model we've tried. Convertible, of course, it's a cloth top. You do hear considerably more noise coming in from the outside. So I'm sure it's apparent on camera. You can actually hear the vehicles passing us along the outside. You can hear horns blaring. In fact, I even experienced people having a conversation on a motorcycle right beside me, and I could clearly hear their conversation. So there's quite an appreciable amount of street noise that actually makes it inside the cabin. That's the price you pay for having the option of running it with a top down.